10 things that you should never go to Vegas without. I already made a video on this, but that was things that I thought people might not have thought of. For this one, we're doing the basics, the things that everyone should be bringing and you must not forget. Liquid IVs. Most people are gonna be doing a lot of drinking in Vegas. And even if you aren't, you're in the desert. It's hot and it's dry. You have to make sure you stay hydrated. Now, I'm not sure how much of the liquid IVs are marketing gimmicks and if they work any better than Gatorade, but their single-use packaging is really convenient. And any electrolyte drink is gonna be way better than just plain water. Comfortable shoes. It's nearly universal that everyone says that they do the most walking that they have ever done in Vegas. And even if you don't plan to walk around and explore, these casinos are enormous. Just walking to the pool is probably a half mile walk in most of them. Make sure you have some good running or walking shoes, and you want them to be like new, but you don't want them to be like fresh out of the box. Break them in a little and make sure they're gonna work. There's nothing worse than finding out your brand new shoes are giving you blisters on your first day of vacation. Cash. And no, I don't mean just because Vegas is expensive and you're gonna be spending a lot of money. You're gonna want some cash for gambling, tipping, taxis. The ATM fees in the casinos are absolutely ridiculous. And a lot of places will charge you extra fees if you don't pay in cash. And also, I'm pretty skeptical of people skimming your card numbers in Vegas. I don't really trust most of the little shops and convenience stores. I try to pay in cash as much as I can. Alcohol. Most people bring at least some alcohol to Vegas. It's not absolutely necessary, as CVS, Walgreens, the ABC store, they're all pretty reasonably priced on the strip. But most people still bring some. That way, as soon as you get there, you can start Vegasing without having to go and run errands. You can carry as much as 5 liters in a check bag. I always put a couple wraps of electrical tape on the lid just to have a little peace of mind that it's not gonna leak. In your carry-on though, you're allowed as many mini bottles of alcohol as you can comfortably fit into a quart Ziploc bag. Keep in mind that you're not allowed to drink them on the plane, but hypothetically, you could go into the bathroom in the airport and pour some into a juice bottle and then carry that on. Sunscreen. Vegas is a desert, and you're probably gonna want some sunscreen. You can buy it at Walgreens, but it's just one more thing you're gonna have to run an errand for, and it's gonna be more expensive and with a crappy variety. We always bring a giant pump of the lotion kind, and then a couple cans of the sprays as well. Earplugs. This one's a just in case that you should always bring. You probably won't even need them, but you might, for a couple reasons. Many of the casinos have clubs that go way late into the night. And if you happen to get a room that you can hear the music, it's gonna be a nightmare. And you probably don't wanna deal with trying to change rooms at like 2 o'clock in the morning. And then the other reason, you might have loud neighbors. And you're gonna really regret forgetting these if you wake up in the middle of the night to a bed getting slammed into your wall and people screaming, if you know what I mean. Ibuprofen. There's a good chance that somebody is gonna wake up after a night of drinking not feeling the greatest. You also might get really sore from all the walking. Again, you can buy this stuff at the convenience stores, but it'll be expensive, and it's just one more thing you're gonna have to deal with. It's easier just to come prepared with a few medical supplies inside of a Ziploc bag. A portable phone charger. If you're anything like us, some days we leave our room first thing in the morning, and then we don't get back until really late. It's really nice being able to charge up your phone throughout the day. Another thing you could add to it is some short 6-inch cords so you don't have to deal with them getting tangled up. A clothespin or a chip clip. It seems like all of the curtains in Vegas don't quite close all the way. Don't know why curtains are so hard to engineer, but if you find that yours don't close and you don't want to wake up when the sun comes up, it's nice being able to pin the curtains closed. Another benefit is that it keeps the heat out. For some reason, that little sliver of light just seems to be too much for the air conditioners to handle. Make sure your curtains are pinned all the way shut before you leave in the morning. Snacks. As a general rule of thumb, food in Vegas is ridiculously expensive. If you wake up in the middle of the night, it's nice having something there on your bedside without having to run downstairs. Or if you're out sightseeing and you aren't always gonna wanna pay like $14 for a bagel or whatever. And when I go a little crazy with it. Our airlines give us more bags than we need, so I pack an entire suitcase with nothing but snacks. And you don't have to do that, you don't have to pack that much, but it's nice having a few things just in case you want them. Sometimes I just want a little bit of trail mix to hold me over so I don't go buy something and then be full before we go spend $200 on dinner. If you have anything that you bring on vacation that you think is really genius, let me know about it down in the comments. I'm definitely gonna be making more of these packing for Vegas videos, so watch out for those. Thanks for watching.